Okay, I want to talk about the future of exchanges. Now, exchanges are very pivotal in the development and the scalability of cryptocurrencies in the upcoming years. I truly believe that cryptocurrencies and the blockchain is not fully decentralized. Now, I will give you some of the reasons in a subsequent video. I will tell you the reasons that the problems of public key addresses. And in this video, I'll be talking about the problem of exchanges. Now, if you've no exchanges, you have the centralized exchanges and decentralized exchanges. Now, you have people like Bitrace, Poloniex, Bitstamp, and some of the rest of them, Bitfinex, and the rest of them. Now, we've been having issues with these guys. There are issues where they complain that where they actually complain, maybe they were hacked, or maybe too much transaction fees. These are flaws. I will present to you to some of the news that are happening with crypto space. Do you know Bitrace has actually seized their literally head hostage their accounts of people for a while? Do you know that? And look at the news that that people are saying about Bitrace leaked documents with headphones and altcoin pumps. Bitrace faces increased scrutiny. I want to say this to you that the space is not complete if until there is total decentralization. There is price manipulation by these guys, and if you've traded stocks before, you will know how prices are being manipulated by these brokers. So Bitrace doing the job of a broker, I don't really agree. I don't know. There are many people in the crypto space who are actually be talking about this thing. Bitrace should go. Bitrace should go. Coinbase should go. All these services should go. We want decentralization in the system. Now, see the news. Prominent cryptocurrency exchange Bitrace have come under heavy under scrutiny in recent weeks. A Russian Telegram channel indicates that a customer was accidentally forwarded passport documentation and other sensitive data for users of the exchange in an email generated by the exchange. How could you make such a silly mistakes? Also, a number of Iranian traders are complaining that they have been blocked from using the platform and thus rendered unable to withdraw funds held on Bitrace. That is absolute rubbish. Lastly, a self-confessed market manipulator professes to have purchased a Tesla with profits generated by conducting altcoin pump and dump on the exchange. You see that? That is rubbish. Bitcoin accidentally shares KYC data of users via email. How can you accidentally share people's sensitive data? It's not good. It's not good. Not good. Not good. And the issue of people's phone actually being hacked for a while. Do you know the most annoying thing? This is the annoying thing. Bitrace sent an email to some of their customers. Do you know what they said? They said the people whose accounts has been frozen and cannot actually withdraw, there are less than 1%. Do you know that? That's an insult to the community, because you are saying that less than 1% of the community, and you have received over 250,000 requests on such similar issue, and you're not attending to them. What is that? That is crazy. That is the news for Bitcoin, and they are not responding. Twitter, Facebook support email, nothing. They are not responding. I think their time is up. They need to go out of the space. Let me bring you a news now. Serene Labs, they were able to raise $64 million under 10 hours. That is incredible, incredible. I knew that this project was going to succeed. I did a video on it. I want to tell you this. I have participated in ICOs. Every ICO, I have had 80% success. Over 80% success on all ICOs I have participated in. So I know what I'm telling you. I'm not just kidding you because I need to tell you, no. I studied the platforms. I don't care how long the pages are. I studied the platforms and I give you the updates. So guys, do have a very good day. Thank you. Bye.